The district attorney's office telling us that this case was the most horrific case they have ever tried here in Madison County, at least in the last 30 years. Christopher Henderson being kept right here in Madison County at the jail until the Department of Corrections comes to bring him to death row.
The reason we have this penalty is for cases exactly like this.
Assistant District Attorney Tim Gann did not hold back moments after Henderson learned his fate, 6 years after he murdered five people, including his second wife, Kristen Chambers Henderson, and her unborn baby.
It's really the most awful thing that you could imagine, killing little kids and women and the unborn. It's unspeakable what he did.
Henderson said nothing as he was escorted out of the courtroom.
There's no way this family is ever going to be made right. This is all that we can do here on earth to get earthly justice is this penalty. That's it. So this is all we can do. Is it enough for what he did? No, it's not.
Defense attorney Bruce Gardner argued for the judge to spare Henderson's life, but even he knew that was unlikely in this case.
I am not surprised. This was a really tough case, and you know, the facts are the facts, and they were just horrendous to have to deal with. And
it's been all about him this whole time. He is kind of the ultimate narcissist. You know, what he did in this case is unfathomable to most folks. And he should have took it like a man. That's what he should have done.
Inside that courtroom, we heard from Henderson as he talked to the judge. He apologized to the family, but he still believes he will be vindicated of these charges. We also learned that during his time here in Madison County at the jail, he tested positive for COVID-19 and ended up in Huntsville Hospital fighting for his life before he was given the death sentence. Reporting in Huntsville, Matt Kroschel, Way 31 News.
Henderson's co-defendant, Rhonda Carlson, Henderson's first wife, entered a guilty plea in this case. Now, she's charged with more than a dozen counts of capital murder. She took a plea deal to avoid the death penalty. Carlson faces a sentence of life in prison without the possibility of parole. As part of that deal, she's expected in court October 27th.